Well, today, boys and girls, today is going to be the turbo assembly day. I was waiting on getting some muffler cement. I wanted to, apparently this stuff is really good stuff, and then you can seal up any leaks. I guess to explain what I'm talking about, I got this back from the machine, or not machine shop, but from the turbo rebuilder. What happened was it had a good bearing, but this was chewed up out of it. Now this is an upgraded turbo, and basically a BEW. This is your stock ALH one, and see the inside of it right there. See the size of that. Well, this is an upgrade. This is a lot bigger, so the fins have to, be form fitted to it. The BW is similar to, exactly like this, only this one had, it was like chewed out. That was one side, and then the other side, see how bad it was? They like silicone it on and glued it on. So I was able to get one of these from the turbo shop. This is an obsolete part, you can't get it. It's a European stuff, European part, and this is the GT 1749 VB by Garrett. So anyways, it's very hard to find one of these things, but I was able to get this and get that. I emailed all over the states and whatnot trying to find one, and all the my European connections, I tried getting one, and it's one of those things where you don't know, I'd rather just grab one from the core turbo, but nobody wants to be bothered to look it up for you to see if they can get one or whatever. So anyway, so this project has been on hold for a long time. Ideally I wanted to get one that had just the ordinary output, just like an ALH, so then it'd be like a more universal VNT 17. But this you can get an adapter that's like this and put it in there and just clip it on there. We have all the parts to make this guy work. You don't necessarily have to, in order to make it work with your ALH, we have enough piping and whatnot. We could make it what we need it to be. We could sell that to a customer. So I guess what's holding me up now is I have to find that little O-ring that slips in that groove right there. So I gotta go digging and find one of those. I got one somewhere around here. I'm backed up with all these heads and everything that need to be addressed. I got parts ones, and then I have good ones that need to go back together. Then we have the PD engines that, all the heads and whatnot. A lot of these are parts, but I should be able to get a new one put together. It's just a matter of cleaning them up and whatnot. We were going through all the blocks and sorting what we had, what we didn't have. And anyways, so I wanted to take this one apart and use some gasket maker. So this one at one time was taken apart and cleaned, and you can see that how black it is. This would be a Volkswagen Passat diesel BHW engine coat. So I guess where would it show it the best? Right there. You can see it was losing boost through here, right there. This guy, you can see the gap. You can see the gap right there. That's where it was losing all of the boost. So basically it has to come apart. And actually, the gasket's only on, the gasket's only on the aluminum side. The exhaust side is just bolted in. So here and there, I'm going to take it apart, and I'm going to use this muffler cement and fill that gap in, and hopefully that should be up and going. So with this VNT 17, I want to call it, basically, this is going to go on only one way. So you have there's a pin. Yeah. There's a couple. This is hard with one hand. Oh man, it's like bottomed out already. There's a couple different ways I can do this turbo. So this would be an upgrade for the ALH and the BEW. So this is an even bigger turbo. What I can do is I can go with a normal ALH with the vacuum. So I can go like that with the actuator. Actually, it goes like that. So that moves that guy like that. I can go with a couple different actuators. So let's see here. Oh man, I've just got so much crap here all over the place. I gotta do a cleanup. I can go with a smart actuator. I can go with a regular ALH actuator. I can go with one of these ones, which is just vacuum operated. And this is vacuum operated as well, but it has the electrical connection inside of it. And so I haven't decided what way we're going to go with it. But for mock-up purposes, I think I'm just going to go... This one. I'm going to take this one and make this one work. I might have the seal in this thing. This little kit has a whole bunch of stuff in it. All the loose stuff, like snap rings and whatnot, I always keep in this thing because you don't want to lose those precious parts. They're, you know, kind of hard to come by. Anyway, so I'm going to see what way I'm going to go, or if I had a buyer lined up for the BW method, or if they want the ALH method. And this actuator was a homemade actuator. What I wanted to do was mock up these. See this? This was one that was modified. We cut it from, this was on like a GM car or whatever. It's the right dimensions. It holds the pressure great and everything. It retracts even better than the original. And we modified that to make it work. So now I have to modify these holes in order to fit this hole. Anyways, it's pretty close, but it's just off enough to be annoying. So basically what we're going to do is give the option to the customer if they want to go with the BW or ALH setup, or they could just go like this with the BW, but you have to get a tune, otherwise your engine light will come on. So I've got all this here. Now I just need to find that gasket, and then I should be able to go. I bought a new tool today. This thing, I wore out my Lyle. It basically got used so much that it actually wore out. Now there's rebuild kits for this blue point. So this one is the blue point, and then the part number, focus, YA4000B. So anyways, this was on sale today, and kind of lucked out on that. This is both pressure and vacuum. So I'm going to put this to use. So many actuators are vacuum, but there are other ones that are pressure. So this is one tool that does both. I think my Lyle, not on sale, was $100. And I used it so much that we actually wore it out. So this thing will get a good workout. And it's really simple to, you know, you just turn it and then you're able to use that. It comes with a whole kit, so you're able to do the actual brake bleeding by yourself and whatnot. I'm doubtful that we'll be doing a whole lot of that, but you know, it's nice to know that you have a tool that'll be able to do it. Come on, you stupid! So there's everything that you need to do. There's the cap for that guy, for the brake fluid and everything. The user manual and all that stuff. So all this stuff is rebuildable. So, and you got all the fittings and whatnot. Those are not guaranteed, but the gun is. And like I said, I use mine so much that I actually was starting to leak right here on my Lyle. So I got one for the truck, and I got one for one on the road, and I got this one for the shop. And man, will I put it to good use. But anyways, I better get to work here. Got to get this apart again. Put some muffler cement, find the seal, rubber seal for this guy, and then put this guy on there. But yeah, basically you can plug the part numbers in there. Stupid camera's not working today. Anyway, so it is an upgrade Garrett turbo, and this should do well for making some power. So anyways, thanks for watching, commenting, and subscribing, and until next time.